Question, the member from Davenport.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have a question for the Minister of the Environment. Mr. Minister, you gave green light to the approval of the Georgetown Corridor rail expansion environmental assessment, which includes the Pearson Union Line. At the same time, however, you also introduced 18 strict conditions placed on the approvals, that is, the expansion. However, there are some questions that need to be answered. One of the important questions that need to be answered is your condition that all trains running along that line be Tier 4 diesel trains, which are supposed to be clean. Now, some of my constituents want to know what exactly are these Tier 4 diesel trains and when will they be available, and how will they protect human health and our environment?
Well, thank you very much, Speaker. Let me first of all applaud the member both from Davenport and from York Southwestern for their advocacy in this matter, because they've been very concerned about this throughout. Speaker, the 18 tough conditions include the requirement that Metrolinx implement the newest technology, the Tier 4 engine technology. Now, while the technology is not yet available, the EPA standards in the states have changed to the effect that they have to be available by 2015. From past experience, when these kind of conditions are imposed by the EPA, manufacturers will actually design to the EPA standards. So they know what the standards are expected of them by 2015. It means that the newest line will have the newest technology right from day one, because the line is expected to come on stream by 2015. The result will be, Speaker, that there will be a 90% reduction in the particulate matter that is being emitted over the technology that's available today, and also
supplementary
nitrogen oxide.
Reduction of nitrogen oxide. I'd like to know more about that. Thank you, Mr. Minister. While the decision on the environmental assessment has been made, there remains much more to be done. At a recent meeting attended by more than 1,000 residents, one issue was pretty prominent. My constituents want to know that they will continue to be consulted. In what way? One of the conditions, Mr. Minister, that you placed on this Metrolinx development, you actually imposed these 18 conditions, and they need to be implemented in terms especially about air monitoring and the reporting plan. That's my question. For instance, the Toronto District School Board's Health Committee voted to have a role in the ongoing air monitoring study. Mr. Speaker, will the minister accommodate their request and include the TDSB and our residents in the decision-making process, since they are directly affected by this significant—
Thank you, Minister.
Let me just continue my answer from before, Speaker. That the new technology will have a 90% particulate matter reduction, as well as an 80% nitrogen oxide reduction, Speaker. And yes, one of the other conditions is the fact that Metrolinx has to develop and implement an ambient air monitoring and reporting plan, and that plan must be put into place after consultation with the public. Obviously, the Toronto District School Board will be consulted throughout. They've got a major interest in this as well, as there are schools in the immediate area. Metrolinx, as a matter of fact, is required to create a working group that contains, at minimum, Toronto Public Health, Environment Canada, and I would strongly suggest that it would include the Toronto District School Board, as well as, obviously, public from the general area. Speaker, we want to make sure that we can reduce the amount of pollution that's in the air by getting as much transit in the GTA as available. This is a major step forward, but we also want to make sure—
New question.